Hello lovely souls, welcome back to my channel Divine Tea with Luna. This video is for why I was absent for the last 2 weeks. So, as we all know, a lot of planets are in retrograde and we are all experiencing heavy energies. And this is not just me, again, I find a lot of us in the collective are going through this at this moment. And I truly believe that, at least coming from my experience, I was dealing with intense energies, very dense energies, heavy energies, and I have been going back to my past and healing it. I have had so many things that I needed to deal with in terms of my past, in terms of my healing. It will not be very wrong to say that I was actually breaking ancestral patterns. Everything that has been happening in my life, and especially in terms of my family, there have been many things that have been happening, and I just really wanted to deal with it, because going forward in 2020, going forward next year, I don't want my life to be the same way anymore. I don't want my past holding me back. I do not want things from my past coming and haunting me in my present or in my future. So when I actually, what the universe did was, it actually completely was like, stop. You will not be able to do anything. It went to such an extent. This is my side hustle, this channel. I hope it eventually becomes my main hustle. But on the side, I also teach Mandarin. So what eventually happened was, I got so tired, I was mentally so distraught, that I even told my students that, listen, I need a time out for a few days, and my mental health is not optimum for me to continue taking classes. And I did that. And for the past 2 weeks, I've been so depressed and down that there have been days where I just only was on the bed. There were days I didn't do anything except for feeling and thinking. And so many things from my past are coming up. And I saw a pattern. My closest people were going through it, and I feel it's a lot of us. It's not just me or like a handful people, not at all. We are a huge number. We have been dealing with the old timeline, so to speak, and it's going to happen to all of us. Like, we need to deal with it. And we need to leave it in the past, because again, a lot of you who know me personally or otherwise, I haven't been very vocal about it on the platform, but I actually am heavy into ET wisdom. I really take a lot, I really study, I watch a lot of videos on extraterrestrial channelings, and from that I have gotten to know, and this is something that you can accept or dismiss. That's all up to you. But if you find a message that resonates with you, it is for you. So I understood from everything that I studied and read that 2020 is crazy. 2020 is a huge marker in terms of the past and the present. So it is very, very important for us to make the decisions right now. It's very important for us to make the correct decisions in the sense, in terms of our healing, because we are changing on an quantum level, atomic level, I feel, because so much is happening, like it does not happen this way. And I want to tell you a fun fact that when they were changing all calendars, like the Mayan calendar to the Gregorian calendar, they actually lost 8 years. So remember that December 21st, 2012 solar eclipse? That's actually if we are to believe this piece of information, it's actually supposed to be this year, but we'll see how that turns out. But I don't really feel like, then there's something in the spiritual community, nothing is standardized, right? And since nothing is standardized, so we cannot know for sure which thing to believe and which thing to not believe. But even if this piece of information is not true in that sense, but what is true? What is the truth? Because we live in a post-truth world now. Please Google whatever that means. I'm not going to explain that here in this video. So, coming back, I still feel 2020 is a major thing. And it's, if we just look at it from a more layman terms, we also understand that, see, 2020 is also just the beginning of this new decade, right? So a lot of us get hopeful, okay, this is going to be my decade, okay? And even if we have to just look at it from that point of view, I actually have been living my authentic truth ever since last year ending. And this year was crazy for me till today. In the sense of what I'm doing, my work, what I want to do in the future, my future opportunities, how I want my life to go, in which direction I want my life to go. All of it together is coming right now. So, for example, I started this channel. And this channel has been a real soul calling for me, because I think I need to share everything that I know, and I need to share what I'm learning as I go. This journey is not going to end, but we can just hope that we are making the best of it. And I just want to help people along the way. That has been my motive from day one. And that's what I'm trying to do here. Another thing, intense healing is taking place, and healing would actually entail for you to go back to your past and deal with everything that you did not deal with. So even I am getting flashbacks from things that happened 10 years back. So something that happened 10 years back, that still has an effect on me. And it's not just me, because whatever is happening to me is also representative of what is happening to others. We might feel that, oh, I'm an individual, this is my. It's actually not. It's actually, you are a part of a collective, and you unknowingly always affect others. Whatever action you take has a ripple effect. Yeah. So on and so forth. So last 2 weeks I've been working on myself. I've been working on my rage issues. I've been trying to get out of depression. And at one point I just got this message that, you know what, you don't need to do. You just need to be still. Be still. And yes, I was not meditating properly for a whole month now, I think. And that also had an effect. But I'm just trying to get back on track. I understood that even before I can help others, I have to help myself. And this actually goes on for a lot of us, because actually, like I keep saying, a lot of us are healers, and all of us are psychic. We all have psychic abilities. It's just that we have not developed them, or we don't know about it. And I understood that I have to really get my spiritual practice, my everyday spiritual practice in place. So before I can go crazy about, okay, what video I'm supposed to do today? Oh, I'm supposed to do a daily mini reading. Oh, I need to get up and get to it before even I have breakfast. You know, those things, those are the things that I think I really need to work on. And I have been. And I just hope that I'm better at channeling after this. So last time I had only uploaded a few videos of Oracle. I only did the water signs, but I hope by tomorrow I'll have everything ready. And my August predictions are also coming. I also have a love prediction coming up. So, yes, that's about it. So, another announcement that I wanted to make was Luna has started a new podcast on Anchor. So, I'm going to link it down below. Please follow me on Anchor because I've already made the first episode and it's on manifestation and a very brief account of how I manifested things in my life. And go listen to it. And actually that is just one episode of a larger context. So I'm going to talk more about manifestations. I'm going to break it down. I'm going to talk about all the laws that other people don't talk about or maybe they don't know. But there are other laws except for the law of attraction. And no, I'm not talking about the hermetic principles. And well, there are a lot of things out there, but we're going to tackle it one by one. Another thing that I wanted to tell you is that I'm going to create a new playlist in which I'm going to give you summaries of the spiritual books that I have read and which have really left me with great insight. So I'm also going to make an audio on, I'm also going to do that on the podcast as well. And I'm going to do that on YouTube. So let me know in the comments what kind of book you would want me to do first. Because even though I have my own choices and picks already, and I'm working on it. So yeah, let's see. And I'm going to try and do oracle messages for every zodiac every week, and there'll be a monthly zodiac taroscope as well. So yes, this is what I've been planning, and wish me luck. Hope that I've dealt with things a little bit so it does not hamper my work. And see, this is also wrong. Like, you should deal with your things and your emotions. You should not always try to cover it up with work. But I want to work because this is really one of my callings and I have to answer the call. So with that, I'm signing off. See you later on. Bye-bye.